Take the example of another companion, Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu, very unknown sahabi. He's not very common in regards to narrating ahadith. Very few ahadith has been mentioned by him. Abdullah bin Hudhafa, upon occasion, he was caught by the companions, he was drinking alcohol. But even, look at this, Allahu Akbar, even a alcoholic, now our belief is every companion who committed a mistake, it was for our betterment so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could reveal certain injunction. This companion, he drank a bit of alcohol and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered the sahaba to beat him up. So they hit him with slippers, they hit him with different objects just to make him realize the mistake that he has done. So whilst they were hitting him, another companion, he made a curse against his sahabi and he said, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy you. May Allah do this to you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam heard him and he said, don't say this about your own Muslim brother. Don't help shaitan against your own Muslim brother. If he's done a mistake, doesn't matter. This doesn't make him even more evil than shaitan himself. This is only a slight mistake. Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu, later on in his life, you know what this man done for the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Allahu Akbar. When you read this story, tears come to your eyes, my brothers. Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu is sent by the companions to go and fight against the Romans, the biggest superpower at the time. He's captured by the Roman soldiers. They take him to Heraclius and they say to Heraclius, we have a very prized possession to give to you. So Sahaba, many other Tabi'een and many other Sahaba are caught, but from amongst all the Sahaba, Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu is the one who was the most closest to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time. He was the ambassador of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they bring him to Heraclius and Heraclius makes him stand in front of him and he says, who are you? He says, I am the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he says, I am the closest to them from amongst my people, amongst my group. So Abdullah bin Hudhafa is told, request by Heraclius, he says to him, he says, do you know what? Let's make a deal. You know, today, my brothers, the situation we live in today, you have scholars who sell their religion for a dollar and a dime, and you have our own people who are ready to kill our own Muslim brothers and sisters just for a few pounds and pennies. There was Shaykh Abdullah Azam, rahmatullah alayh. Do you know what this man said? He said, when you have an enemy and you have your own people, he said, keep one bullet for your enemy and keep 10 for your own people. Because your own people are the ones who are going to destroy you more than your enemy. And this is a reality which we see today, my brothers. Abdullah bin Hudhafa radhiyallahu anhu is standing there and he says to Abdullah bin Hudhafa, he says, I will give you half of my kingdom if you are ready to accept Christianity. Abdullah bin Hudhafa radhiyallahu anhu, he says, if you're going to give me all of your kingdom, it doesn't make a difference to me. I am going to remain as a Muslim. So he says to him, okay, I will give you half of my kingdom and I will give you my daughter to get married to. You can take her, do whatever you want, and I will keep you very close to me. Abdullah bin Hudhafa radhiyallahu anhu said, by Allah, if you give me everything, even if you give me 10 women, I'm not going to change my religion, my belief in regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and my belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Heraclius, the main part I'm coming to, my brothers, Allahu Akbar. He says to his soldiers, throw him into prison. So he's in prison for a couple of days. For about a week he's in prison. Whilst he's in prison, he's stuck inside the prison cell. Heraclius sends his soldiers and says, send some prostitutes so that he can fall into temptation and he can commit zina, adultery. So a woman goes inside the prison cell and Abdullah bin Hudhafa, he wasn't an ordinary man, he was a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's like breaking a glass with a small little needle, impossible. So they send the woman and the woman goes inside the room and she tries to make him look towards herself so that she could seduce him. So this man, Abdullah bin Hudhafa, is sitting in the corner doing the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she's trying to control him, trying to make him look towards his side, but he's not doing anything. So she comes out of the room and goes back to Heraclius. And she says, have you sent me to a man or a stone? I did not even see anything from him. So then a couple of days later, they pull him out of the prison. And Heraclius says to Abdullah bin Hudhafa that I'm going to kill you and all your friends with you. He says, no problem. Bring whatever you want to bring. I'm not going to change my religion. So they bring another man from the group of Abdullah bin Hudhafa. They pick him up and they throw him in a cauldron which was filled with boiling hot oil. And they throw him inside, they take him out and all you could see is a cooked man. His flesh could be seen and his meat fully cooked. So Abdullah bin Hudhafa radhiyallahu anhu is standing there watching this man just give his life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Heraclius says, take Abdullah bin Hudhafa now. Take him and do the same thing. So while they're taking him, he starts crying. Abdullah bin Hudhafa starts crying. And then the king, Heraclius, he says to his people, he says, see, I've broke this man. I've broken him. Bring him back to me. So they bring him back and they say, Abdullah, you've got another chance. Change your religion and you can be a close friend of mine. Abdullah bin Hudhafa, what does he say? Words that should be written with gold, my brothers. He turns to Heraclius and he says, by Allah. He said, don't think I was crying because I am scared of death, or I am crying because I am scared of leaving this dunya and meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, the only reason why I am crying is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has only given me one life. And I can only sacrifice one life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, tamannaytu anna li mi'ata nafs. I wish and I have a desire that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given me 100 souls. I would give each soul for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then what happens? Heraclius is broken. He's broken. So what does he say? He says, okay, leave him. We don't want to throw him in the cauldron. He says, one more option you have. He said, kiss me on my forehead and I will let you go. Kiss me on my forehead and I will let you go. Now look, this is the point I wanted to mention, my brothers. Abdullah bin Hudhafa, if that was me or you, we would have said, Alhamdulillah, I'll kiss your feet as well and I'm ready to go. What did Abdullah bin Hudhafa say? He said, if I kiss your head, will you let me go and the Muslims? Will you let me go and the Muslims? Heraclius said, I will let you go and the Muslims. Abdullah bin Hudhafa said, okay, this is fine with me. So he kissed the forehead of Heraclius and Heraclius said, let him go and let all the other people go as well. My point, my brothers, is Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu did not only have concern for himself, he had concern for his own Muslim brothers as well. And this is very rare to see, my brothers, in our day and age. Everyone is concerned about himself. No one cares about anyone else. We don't care about our Muslim brothers anywhere in the world. Now what did Umar radiallahu anhu do? He heard about this story. He heard about this story. Abdullah bin Hudhafa, he starts traveling back to Medina with a group of these companions who have been released by Heraclius. And he stands on the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Umar radiallahu anhu, and he makes an announcement and he says to all the Muslims, he says, it is wajib upon every Muslim brother in Medina to Munawwara to kiss the head of Abdullah bin Hudhafa radiallahu anhu. And he said, I am the first one to do it. And he kissed the head of Abdullah bin Hudhafa. Why? One of the reasons he kissed his head was because he had love and compassion for the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So my brothers, we need to understand, time doesn't permit me to go further, we need to understand, my brothers, that until we don't have concern for the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are going to be disgraced, we are going to be persecuted, and we will see much more worse what we are seeing today.